unto me. I come before thee today to bring another video. Not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Man. And I had to ask that she bless my crystalline eye, heart, and throat chakra, but all my chakras, that I may speak not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. And I say one of my beloved precepts, which is Psalms 51:11. And it goes a little bit like this. Cast me not away from thy presence. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me thy joy of thy salvation. And uphold me with all thy free spirit. Look at the glory. Only through the Shekinah that is from the Father shall we get over standing. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, we're going to talk about some of the ministries that she provides for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? You want to contact us? Go to Upper Eons on Facebook. You want to contact us? Go to Upper Eons on Facebook. You know what I'm saying? The best way to contact us truly is through our websites in the description box at the bottom of the video. You know what I'm saying? We got my big brother Rodolph email, which is dotheman@al.com. dotheman@al.com. That's my big brother Rodolph. You know what I'm saying? Then you got my email, dbisrael@gmail.com. You know what I'm saying? Then we got a food ministry. Named after my big brother Rodolph's beloved mother, Chandra Johnson. You know what I'm saying? You know any women or children that may need assistance with food, contact us. The information is in the description box at the bottom of the video. Then we got a video ministry by my brother Benaiah and my brother Chase. The information again is in the description box at the bottom of the video. Then Lord's Will, we got a blog talk, Lord's Will, every Sunday at 11 a.m. Then also, we got a PAL talk after that, which is called The Sons of the L, Number 2. That is our PAL talk. Sons of the L, Number 2, all capital letters. And that is at 12 p.m. You know what I'm saying? So these are the ministries that we provide for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? And that information is in the description box at the bottom of the video. You know what I'm saying? So, Today, we're going to look at the title of the video. What it say? It say, ye worship who ye know not. Ye worship who ye know not. John chapter 4, verse 22 in the King James Bible. That's what we're going to talk about today, that you may have overstanding what the Divine Mother is saying. So with that being said, let's move on into the video. I know,
if we give each other love, oh yeah, don't go and talk about my father, cause God is my friend, so she's my friend, he loves us whether or not we know it.
Now, come on. Woo. I truly thank the Divine Mother because she is truly worthy. She is truly worthy. For she give me great understanding of great things of old, that I may give right truth and right knowledge unto the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? The Divine Mother has truly been dealing with me in the spiritual realm. Oh man, downloads left and right. Dreams of great understanding. And I truly thank her for her glory, her wisdom, her knowledge, her truth, her intellect, that I may see and that I may hear what she is saying. Dreams been given to me. I truly thank her. I'm going to take a moment of silence to give to the Divine Mother. Hey, bear with me. Let's take a pause for the Divine Mother. Listen carefully. Look at the glory. Man, let me say something. The great awakening. Oh, man, it is a blessed thing. It is truly a blessed event, how it takes place. On the screen, we got the kings and the gods of the earth in physical form on the left-hand side of the picture. And he has his son in his hands. You know what I'm saying? On the right-hand side, we always see a picture of an Edomite, the 12 disciples, and another Edomite reaching out from heaven, which is your pineal gland and your brain in the physical body. That's the upper room or the heavens. Your true power is your pineal gland, the pituitary gland, and I think the thalamus gland. You know what I'm saying? Those three glands is the three sisters. You see the mother there, and she got 12 women or 12 men with her. See how she touching from the pineal gland or from heaven down to the divine children? You know what I'm saying? It is the mother who do all these things, which is the Holy Spirit. Now, the great awakening, the Divine Mother showed me this in dreams, and I truly thank her. Me and my brother were speaking of this because he was And I'm going to let him talk about it, but he was speaking how the Divine Mother was blessing him to give overstanding to one of his significant others. And I don't say one, meaning he got many. I'm just saying it's somebody that he's very close with. I want to get into the details. Someone who's very close with. And the Divine Mother was having him giving her overstanding of the Divine Mother and what was going on in this reality, this present day. You know what I'm saying? So he called me about a precept that the mother had already given me, that I was already being downloaded to about. You know what I'm saying? It was another video what I supposed to have done. And to keep it real, what I'm talking about today is part of the original video that she was going to bless me to do. You know what I'm saying? But she said, take off that part because it'd be too long. We'll deal with that a little later. You know what I'm saying? But it was confirmation of him calling me at that moment to confirm what the Divine Mother was already showing me. You know what I'm saying? And I thank the Divine Mother for working through all her people, you know, to help confirm what she be showing us. Now, my brother, he asked about a precept, John chapter 4, verse 22. You know what I'm saying? When it said that you shall not, let's go to it. Let's go to it. Let's not just read it. Let's go to it. Let's go to it. Let's go to in the Bible. Let's go to the New Testament. See? The New Testament. The New Age of the coming of the dove. The New Age, not the old. Let's go to John chapter 4. Let's go down. We gonna start at verse 21. It say, this is Messiah talking to a woman of Samaria, or the Samaritans, which was Samaria was a whole bunch of Israelites that fell asleep, and they was Hellenistic Gentiles. Hellenistic Gentiles, that's different from the Gentiles. You know what I'm saying? So he was speaking to the Samaritans who was Israelites who fell asleep. You know what I'm saying? John chapter 4, verse 21. Messiah, and these all in red writing, you know what it's red in me, Messiah talking. Messiah said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in the mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Wait a minute, wait a minute. The whole world worships the Father. Wait a minute. Let me say that again. The whole world worships the Father. The whole world worships the Father. But Messiah said himself in red writing in the King James Bible, John chapter 4, verse 21. Woman, believe me, the hour cometh, mean a time yet to come. At the moment he was speaking with her, it was not that time. When ye neither in the mountain, mean the mountain mean all of Israel. And esoterically, the mountain mean, let me say that again. The mountain means a pyramid. Or when the capstone comes back on your temple, which is a mountain. Your temple is a mountain in esoteric understanding. And the mountain is all of Israel. And it means more than that, but this video ain't about that. It said, neither in this mountain, what is this mountain? See, in this temple, this body, neither in this mountain or the whole nation of Israel is a mountain. And a mountain is a pyramid. I explained to y'all that before. Nor yet at Jerusalem. Your body is Jerusalem too. And Jerusalem is the whole nation of Israel. You know what I'm saying? Nor yet in Jerusalem worship the Father. wait a minute now. Like I said, the whole world worships the Father. You know what I'm saying? Because who he is. You know what I'm saying? Verse 22. But look what Messiah said. He said, ye worship who ye know not. What? See, Messiah told the woman, you worship the Father, but you really don't know what you're worshiping. That's what he telling the Samaritan woman. The woman. All y'all in Israel worshiping the Father, and ye know not what ye really worship. You know what I'm saying? That's what the mother been showing me in all these dreams. Every night, over and over and over and over again, I see men bowing down, speaking to the mother. In my dreams, I saw a nation bowing to the mother. I seen that in my dreams. I seen mighty men of war bowing to the mother. I seen this in my dreams. In many more things. You know what I'm saying? I seen it clear as day, because you know how in your dream you like you standing above the nations or above people and you looking down. And she showed me great things. She showed me wars of great destruction. You know what I'm saying? And she showed me the divine power who sustains her mighty men. You know what I'm saying? So let's read. 1 John chapter 4, verse 22. Ye worship who ye know not what. So he telling her and all of Israel, all of y'all worshiping the Father, but you really don't know what you worship. And she said, we know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. You know what I'm saying? 23. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. When 23 say in spirit and in truth, they took off the word holy. It means you shall worship the Father in the Holy Spirit and in truth. The Holy Spirit and in truth. Meaning, you're going to serve the invisible Heavenly Father. But you're going to worship the mother to do that. The Holy Spirit and truth. Truth is Sophia. The Holy Spirit is Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Which is the feminine principle. Ye worship who you know not. You think you worshiping the Father, but you really worshiping the mother. That's what Christ told the mother and all of Israel. But they had no understanding what he was saying at that present time. He says, it's going to come a time. So, this the point I'm saying to say all of that. Let me turn the music down. This the point I'm saying to say that. If, when the Most High woke up all of Israel, if he woke us all up, remember the time when he woke us up around 2011? 2012, he woke up all of Israel. Well, he started waking everybody up like a wave. You know, it was like a wave that came across the physical realm. And Israelites was waking up all over the earth. You know how a wave goes across the water? It carries the wave across the water. So all of the earth was, if the wave, the divine mother consciousness, the all mind consciousness, was waking up the whole earth of the chosen children like a wave crossing over the earth. You know what I'm saying? And it was, and I remember when it woke me up. The divine mother woke up the men first. She woke up the men first. You know what I'm saying? And we started teaching all over the earth. You know what I'm saying? Mostly in America. You know what I'm saying? And we was given understanding. But at a present time, certain ones in the nation or in the mountain, the nation of Israel, certain men was lit beyond the 66 or 80 books. It was led to the Book of Mormon. It was led to the Pseudepigraphal book. It was led to the Book of Enoch, all three books. They were led to the Book of Enoch, the Book of Knowledge, the Return of the Dove. They was led to the Book of Joshua. They was led to the Testament, the Third Testament. They was led to what's the other Book of the Mormon? And I got it too. I forgot the name of it. But all the aspects of the Book of Mormon, they was led to. You know what I'm saying? They was led to other overstandings. You know what I'm saying? Because the mother knew this. She knew, and I was speaking to Rodolph about this. She knew once she woke up the men, and we was in our ego, we were still telling the woman to shut up and sit down. We were still telling the woman when we was walking Israelites to shut up and sit down. You know what I'm saying? Men are speaking over here. But see, the mother woke the men up to come through the ranks as Hebrew Israelites knew who they were. And then she led them from the 66 to the 80 books. She led them out of them books. You know what I'm saying? Those books are given to the wise and the unwise. But she had the 70 books for the wise alone. You know what I'm saying? For the wise alone. In other great books. You know what I'm saying? Basically what was going on, she had to wake up the men to go beyond the 60 or 80 books and to find out about the mother. She led us to the Book of Sophia. You know what I'm saying? To understand that Sophia was Mary Magdalene. You know what I'm saying? The great mother, Isis. The great mother, Aset. You know what I'm saying? She said, I must wake them up so they can accept the mother. Because how are those men going to go to the women and tell the women that they are the true power, the black woman? If they do not know about the mother, they are not going to be able to tell the women who they really are. Because he's waking up the women now. You know what I'm saying? But he woke up the men first. And they ain't want nothing to do with the woman. They would tell the woman, get in your place. Stay in your place. Shut up. Men talking. But he took the men out of that 60, 80 books. Passed the King James Bible in the Apocrypha. And he took them into other books. So they can know the mother. And then they start learning about the mother. Who she was. What she was talking about. Who the true power was. In the Nag Hammadi. She led them to the Nag Hammadi. And then they found out that the woman was the true power. The source of the strength of Israel. But if he had not woke up the men to come out of those, the Apocrypha in the Bible, they would have never known this. So he had to wake the men up out of the Bible in the Apocrypha and move them on to other books to find out about the mother, Israel's true power. See to the right hand side? You know the picture they got of the man touching a man on earth? And it ain't really a man, it's a black woman. And the man ain't white. You know what I'm saying? I should have put both pictures side by side. But y'all look at the picture, y'all know this picture. Y'all got a white man reaching down from heaven, touching a man on earth, and they touching fingers. Now you got that picture right there of the divine mother reaching down from heaven to all mine. Like those said, the universe is all mine, which is the mind of the mother, which is the Akashic Records, the mind of the mother. That becomes one with divine man to give him great wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of all truth, wisdom, and knowledge, and intellect. So that's why she had to wake up certain men to understand that the mother is the true power, the black woman, like the Nag Hammadi said, the eternal heavenly father, the invisible father, created his first thought was the mother in the Nag Hammadi. His first thought was the mother, the black woman. You know what I'm saying? And she gave birth to the first man, Christ. And Christ thanked the mother. You know what I'm saying? So our true power is the black woman, the all mind, the Akashic Records. know what I'm saying? So that's why she woke up a certain group of men to teach the woman, or not teach the woman, help the black woman remember who she is and that she is the true power of all men. Now, the mother told me this. These are not my words. The mother told me this. She said, I'm going to have you do a video that no man can refute. Let me say that again. The divine mother said, I'm going to have you do a video that no man can refute. That I am the true power of the man. I am his throne. I am the one who gives his throne power. You know what I'm saying? I am the hidden hand. Like Christ said, ye worship who you know not. What? The divine mother is your true power and your true strength. Let's find out. No man gonna be able to refute this. The whole world worships the mother and they don't even know it. Like I said, if the world is upside down and the whole world is worshiping the father, but the world is upside down, that means you should be worshiping the mother. Let's find that out. I'm gonna show you the whole, well, I ain't gonna show you. The divine mother is gonna show you the whole world is worshiping the mother and don't even know it. Let's find that out. The divine mother is truly worthy. All right. Let's read this right here. Let's read this right here. Let's read this precept. Bear with me. Let's read this precept. Okay. Now, I got this off the internet so you can look it up yourself. Okay. It say, John chapter 4, verse 22. On the top verse, it say, you Samaritan, bear with me. It say, you Samaritans who very little, wait a minute. It say, you Samaritans know very little about the one you worship. See that? This Christ talking. He said, you Samaritans know very little about the one you worship. And then they say, well, while we Jews know all about him, for salvation comes through the Jews. See, Christ told him, you Samaritans and all of Israel know very little about the one you worship. See, you really worshiping the mother and you don't even damn know it. You know what I'm saying? And let's go down to the second part. Let's go to the second part. At the bottom, it say, I just put this on there for you. It say, what is John chapter 4, verse 22 talking about? It say, you worship what you do not know. We know what we worship for salvation for the Jews. Christ keep telling you, you worship what you do not know. You think you worshiping the Father, but the Christ told you clearly, it's going to come a time in the future when you ain't going to worship the Father. Because right now you worship what you don't even know what you're worshiping. You worshiping the mother and you don't even know it. And I'm going to show you today, without an inkling of a doubt, the whole world is worshiping the mother and they don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? They worshiping the mother and don't even know it. Let's bring that out. All right. Now, let's go to the left hand side. This is out of the book called Echoes of Darkness. Echoes of Darkness. Look what this say. This say, the upper glyph is the seat or the throne on the left-hand side. It said the upper glyph, the glyph is right there at the top. You see the chair? It's a right angle with a little square inside of it. That's the right angle, but that's also the throne. The right angle is the angel, or the right angle is the mother. I showed you that the right angle is the feminine aspect, the one to point up. The right angle that point down is the physical aspect. So the right angle, the Masonic symbol, the The right angle that face up is newt, the feminine aspect. The right angle that's down or the square is the masculine aspect. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, bear with me, all right. That's why the Masonic symbol, has a compass for the top, which represents, it's a right angle, but a compass is a right angle, but it make a circle, mean feminine. So that's why the compass is on the top of the Masonic symbol. It represents the mother, the woman, because it makes a circle. Circles is feminine. Lines is masculine. And then the bottom part is a square, which represents masculine lines. You know what I'm saying? So it's the upper glyph, that's why I say the upper glyph, the right angle facing up, is the seat or the throne, whose literal meaning is Aset, the Egyptian name of Isis. See that? The Egyptian name of Isis. So the right angle is Isis. You know what I'm saying? The bottom glyph is the eye. See that? Which translates as R or Osiris or IR, meaning creator or begot. So this go back to the divine mother in the Naginati, creating Christ. Osiris is Christ. Horus is Christ. Because Horus was reborn after Set killed him, and he was made into Horus. I mean, Osiris was born as Horus, reborn after Set killed him, his brother. You know what I'm saying? He just was reborn as Horus. But Osiris and Horus is the same entity. So it said, Osiris, meaning create or begotten. See, the begotten is the only begotten son. Thus, Osiris' name in Egyptian is Asar, meaning begotten of Isis. Exactly. Isis is Barbilo, Isis is Pistis, and Isis is Sophia. Isis got many names. Like I said in my last video, she got 99 names in Islam and in Israel. You know what I'm saying? The begotten of Isis. That's the same thing the Nagamati tell you. The Nagamati tell you that the divine mother was the first thought of the invisible father. And her first creation was the only begotten son, Christ, which is Osiris or Horus, which is Christ. Everything in the Bible go back to Israel. I mean, Egypt. And Egypt go back to Atlantis. And Atlantis go back to Nibiru or the Anunnaki. But we ain't gonna get into that. That's another video. Now look at the right hand picture. Look at the picture on the right hand side. What is Osiris sitting on? He's sitting on the right angle. See? The divine mother is your true power. She is the one who put you on the throne. The divine mother is the power. The right angle that put you on the throne. The Masonic symbol. The right angle that's facing up is Nut, the feminine aspect. In the bottom right angle is Geb, the physical aspect. You know what I'm saying? So the divine mother put the male on the throne. She is his true power that makes him rule. That's why Osiris said in my last video, Isis is my best friend. She is my true power. Thoth said the same thing. Isis is my best friend. She is my best, they say Isis is my true companion or consort. Companion means consort. Osiris and Thoth said the same thing. Isis is my true companion. Isis or the mother is your true power. When you say Isis, you're talking about Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia, the three sisters, the true power of every man that rules. In every chosen child. Let's move on. All right. Let's go to the right hand side. I just did that glyph to show you that. Yeah, to show you that ISIS is truly Barbilo, Pisces, and Sophia. It's many other names that they go under, but I'm saying this so mostly everybody can recognize who I'm talking about when you talk about the divine goddesses. Okay, let's go to the right hand side. It said, Set or Isis, the Holy Spirit of biblical text. See, the Holy Spirit, that's why it said in 23, you worship the fathers through the Spirit and truth. Isis, that's why they took off holy. They just said spirit to throw you off. But it really meant Holy Spirit and truth. Isis is the Holy Spirit, and she is truth. She is wisdom, and she is justice. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. It say, on the right-hand side, it say, Isis was one of the oldest gods or goddess of ancient Egypt. But her origins are unclear. Yeah, it's clear. They don't know. She is something thought to have originated in the Sinai. See, the Sinai. When Moses was talking to God, that was the divine feminine aspect he was speaking to. Metatron, the feminine aspect. That's who Moses was talking to at Mount Sinai. Originated in Sinai, but is also likely that she was first worshipped as a fetish in the Delta, talking about in Egypt, the Delta, at Lower Egypt, around Borsiris, the location of the oldest known cult. See, cult just means hidden. Centers of Osiris. However, her cult was not limited to one area, but worshiped in every temple in the land. In fact, the first shrine dedicated specifically to her was built Necrotonable in Destiny 30. We ain't gonna get into that. It said the cult of Isis, the Egyptian goddess, was very popular through Egypt and beyond, and she became a goddess of almost limitless attributes. Isis was her Greek name, but she was known to the ancient Egyptians as Eset or Esti. See that? What I just showed y'all. Esti on the left-hand side. Esti is Isis. Esti, Iset, Upset, which is usually translated as feminine, of throne, or queen of the throne. See that? The divine mother put you on the throne. You ain't gonna sit on the throne without the divine mother. So that's why Osiris, which is Horus, and Thoth, which is Enoch, said Isis is my best companion or my consort. Queen of the throne, her original headdress and empty throne. See that? Her headdress is an empty throne. And she make the man sit on that empty throne. An empty throne, and as the personification of the throne, she was an important source of the Pharaoh's power. See that? The Pharaoh cannot rule without Isis or Barbilo, Pisces, or Sophia right there with him. You know what I'm saying? That is every king's true power, the mother. You will not rule without the mother. She is the hidden hand of the true power of every king and every god, period. You know what I'm saying? So that's why Christ said in John chapter 4, verse 22, Ye worship who you know not. Ye worship who you know not. Ye worship who ye know not. You worshiping the mother and you don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? That's why I told you. When all of Israel, every new moon, I got an Israelite texting me talking about, Happy New Moon, dear. Happy New Moon. I showed y'all in my last video, the moon is the mother. Why is all the holidays of Israel on a new moon? All seven holidays on a new moon. Israel is worshiping the mother and they don't even know it. I can't get past a new moon without an Israelite sending me a text talking about Happy New Moon, the dear, worshiping the mother and don't even know it. Every last one of the holidays I showed you on my last video is on a new moon, which is the mother. All of Israel worship the mother and don't even know it. And Christ told you himself, you worship who you know not. You worship the mother and you don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on. All right. Let's go to the Nag Hammadi. Let me show you Christ. Christ told you the same thing in the Nag Hammadi. You worship the mother and you don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the Nag Hammadi. I'm going to break this down today. Ain't no male ego going to be able to refute what I'm going to show you today. Well, not me. What the Divine Mother going to show you today. Can't no male ego refute what Divine Mother is showing you today. No male ego. Now, you could deny it if you want, but you're only hurting yourself. Because the Divine Mother said, if you deny me, you will not receive my gifts. So any male ego that deny the mother and don't worship her, you will not receive her gifts. Period, point blank. She is the great mother. She is Big Mama. That's why they made movies called Big Mama. She is the one to keep everything together. She is the one that keeps everything together, Big Mama. That is Barbie and her two daughters, Pistis and Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Let's go on to Nag Hammadi. Like Christ said in John chapter 4, verse 22, ye worship who ye not know. Ye worship who ye not know. Ye worship who ye not know. You worship the mother and don't even know it. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the Nag Hammadi. Let's go on to Nag Hammadi on page 167. Let's go on to Nag Hammadi on page 167. Let's go to the top and say, three women always walked with the master. Who is the master? Messiah. Three women always walk with Messiah. Three women always walk with Messiah. Three women always walk with Messiah. Mary, his mother, Barbila, his sister, and Mary Magdalene. See that? Mary, his mother, Barbila, his sister, Pistis, and Mary Magdalene, Sophia. Let me read that again. Three women always walk with Messiah. Mary, his mother, Barbila, his sister, Pistis, and Mary Magdalene, Sophia. Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Mary Magdalene is Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Mary Magdalene is Sophia. Mary Magdalene and Sophia. Mary Magdalene, bear with me. Mary Magdalene is Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Mary Magdalene is Sophia. They ain't fly getting on my nerves. His mother is Barbila. His sister is Pistis. And Mary Magdalene is Sophia. Isis. Wisdom. Proverbs keep talking about wisdom. She, wisdom, Mary Magdalene. See that? Those are the three powers that always walk with Christ. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the bottom half and say, Father and Son are simple names. Holy Spirit is a double name. They are everywhere, above and below, in the hidden and indivisible. See that? In the hidden and indivisible. So she is in the hidden world and in the visible world. In the visible world, you can't see her. But in the hidden world, it's the spiritual realm. But she manifests through the masculine principle. She make the masculine principle rule. She give the masculine principle his power. It is her, Barbie Pisces Sophia. In the hidden and in the visible, the Holy Spirit is the visible, and then is it then is below. And the Holy Spirit is the hidden, and then it is above. See that? We gonna show you today. Ain't no male gonna be able to refute. Let me remember these words right here. And they, wait a minute, it said, the Holy Spirit is in the visible, and then is below. So the invisible is above, and then it is below. And the Holy Spirit is in the hidden, and then in the above. See that? So, ain't no male, no man, gonna be able to deny what I'm about to show you today, what the Divine Mother blessed me to show you today. You gonna know today that your true power is a woman, and she is all over the world, but you just couldn't see her. But that's why I explained in the beginning that she had to wake up Israel, some of the chosen men, to tell the women that the women is the true power. But you had to come out of the Bible in the Apocrypha. You had to get past the 60 and 80 books. You had to go on to other books. And if any man denied the mother and not worshiping the mother, they will not receive her gifts. I showed y'all that in one of my other videos. So you can choose not to worship the mother. That's up to you. Just know it's a twofold issue. Let me turn the music down. If you choose not to worship the mother, then you say to yourself, I don't want her gifts. I'm putting that out there. I showed y'all that the Divine Mother showed me that in a dream. And then she showed me in writing. And I showed y'all in the video. If you don't want to worship the mother, you don't want her gifts. Because she just showed y'all just now that every king that sit on the throne, she is their true power. She is the one that give them wisdom and knowledge and intellect, how to rule, how to do everything. She is the one that give them that power. The whole world seek wisdom to all four corners of the earth and all four corners of the universe. Ain't no man gonna be able to refute what I show you today, that you worship the mother, period, point blank. You know what I'm saying? Now look what I got right there. On the first one, it say that Christ walked with three women at all times, Barbie Lope, Pisces, and Sophia. You see those three windows I put on the top of that? And then it show you the Holy Spirit is above in the visible, and the Holy Spirit is below in the physical, in the visible. See those three windows? Look at the Last Supper. See the Last Supper? This go with the picture I showed you at the beginning. A black woman with the 12 women with her. That's the picture of her reaching down, touching the black man in Christ. She was reaching down, touching him. She is their true power in the hidden world above. And she touches everything down below and gives it its power, the one she deal with. That's why in the Apocrypha, it said that it told the Holy Spirit her resting place was to be in Israel. That's what she rested at. The Holy Spirit only deals with the chosen people, period. Nobody else. You know what I'm saying? Look at the Last Supper. You got the 12 disciples. I got a black one. I got black men. I ain't get the white ones. You know what I'm saying? Because the whole world try to tell you Christ white and the disciples are white. And the Bible clearly tell you many ways that they were black. So-called black people. Carbonated men. You know what I'm saying? Look at the Last Supper. See Christ sitting in the middle? You see six on one side, six on the other side, which is 12. But look behind Christ. See that big window with the arch? That's Barbie Love. See the other two windows? That's Pisces and Sophia. The three windows all over the world, or the three doors, represents Barbie Love, Pisces, and Sophia. That's why Christ said in John chapter 4, verse 3, ye worship who ye know not. Ye worship who ye know not. Ye worship who ye know not. See that? You worshiping the mother and you don't even know it. That's why I said the whole world, that's why Christ said, it's going to come a time in the future when you ain't going to worship the father, you're going to worship the mother. He said the spirit, and in truth, they took off holy off the spirit, so you would notice the Holy Spirit that leads you back to Isis. That's what that wicked ass Edomite did. He took off holy on spirit and said, you shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. You're going to worship the Father, the invisible Father, who you ain't going to never see. You know what I'm saying? Through the Holy Spirit and in truth, which is the divine mother, Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Right behind Christ, you got three windows or three doors. See that? Barbilo is the center door. Pistis and Sophia are the other two doors. Pistis is faith. Sophia is wisdom. That's why the Bible, and all this is in your Bible. Barbilo is the creator or God. Pistis is faith. The Bible keeps talking about have faith, have faith, have faith. Wisdom is Sophia. Wisdom. Give you wisdom. The Bible talk about Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia all throughout the book. Barbilo is the creator. Pistis is faith. Wisdom is Sophia. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Or Mary, which is Barbilo. His sister, which is Pistis, Mary Magdalene, is Sophia. Your own Bible tell you that, but a lot of your male egos refuse to see it and accept it. And like the divine mother said, if you cannot accept me, you will not receive my gifts, because she is the one who put you on the throne. So if you don't want the throne, let me say it again. If you don't want the throne, let me say it one more time. If you don't want the throne, don't accept her. Don't worship the mother. Don't serve the mother, and you ain't gonna receive her gifts. Period, point blank. You know what I'm saying? Christ told you himself, ye worship who ye know not. Ye worship who ye know not. Let's move on. Now I'm gonna show you that the whole world worships the mother and they don't even know it. Okay. Look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Look at that. You worship the mother and you don't even know it. What the top picture say? It said, did not say when it say mountain, it's talking about a pyramid or a mountain, a literal mountain. Okay. It said the pyramids and the stars. The pyramid and the stars. The pyramids and the stars. You see those three stars? Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. See that? Okay, no man in the world deny this. The three stars of Orion's belt. Orion represents Christ. Orion represents Michael. Orion represents Marduk. Marduk is Christ. Because if you go back to the Anunnaki or the Sumerian text, I did a video on that. Orion's belt represents the hunter. That's why the Bible said, first, I shall send for preachers, and teachers or preachers, and they shall teach. Thence, I shall send for hunters, and they shall hunt. You cannot be a hunter without the power of the Holy Spirit. The hunter's going to come when the wave comes. You understand what I am saying? Okay. The three stars is the three sisters. I'm going to show you that. The three stars is the three sisters. Barbilo, the creator, the bigger pyramid. Pistis, which is faith. And Sophia, which is wisdom. Look at the bottom. That's a church at the bottom. Remember in the last video I showed you all the churches around the world with the three doors? See, the bigger door is the bigger pyramid. That's Barbilo. The other door is Pistis, and the other door is Sophia. Those are the three Marys that walk with Christ in all times. We know that Christ is Horus in Egypt. You know what I'm saying? And we know Horus is Osiris, reborn. You know what I'm saying? So the three doors on all the Catholic churches all around the world, and the three doors you found all around the world represents Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Osiris, true power. Thoth, true power. You know what I'm saying? These three doors or windows all around the world represent the three stars in heaven. The hunter's true power is Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. That's why it's on his belt. It represents the true power of the hunter. The hunter is Christ. The hunter is Michael. And the hunter is Marduk. And the hunter is you. You the hunter too. When she wake you up and make you the hunter. You know what I'm saying? See that? Can't no man deny this. No man. Those three stars is the three sisters. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. It's even in the heavens, the invisible realm. And it come down on the physical realm. That's why you had three windows behind Christ at the Last Supper. His true power and his true strength. Let's move on. All right, let's read this. All this on the internet, you can go get it yourself. Now we're talking about a dear lion. I can't find it. Let's read this. Okay, it said, I'm going to consider the three stars in the belt of Orion constellation to be the three sisters. And to me, each star will represent the soul of one of your young ladies. As you know, they are located in the sky where they oversee the great nebula in Orion, which is one of the most glorious objects in the sky. Exactly. That's why Orion's belt is the most significant object in the sky. Go to the yellow part. It said, my story for the constellation will tell of three young women who were sisters before the creation of the heavens and the earth. See that? They was there before the creation of the heavens and the earth. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Sophia is how we fell into all the galaxies of all creation. You know what I'm saying? The fall of the chosen star seeds. But Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia was there before the creation of the heavens and the earth. The three sisters. Look at Christ at the bottom. Barbilo, the middle window. Pistis, the right window. Sophia, the left window. Barbilo, the center window. Pistis, the right window. Sophia, the left window. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. The true power of the hunter. That's why the Bible said the Holy Spirit gonna teach your hands how to war and your fingers how to fight. She is your true power. The Divine Mother had me do this video because very soon she about to return, the return of the dove. She about to give the chosen elect ones who can accept her and who acknowledge her, her gifts, her true power. She gonna make you a hunter. But if you can't accept her, you're not gonna get them gifts. That's why she had me doing these videos. When that wave come, which is the mother, her divine mind, her divine consciousness, is going to come wake up certain people. Only the ones that can acknowledge her, that gives, she going to give her gift to. If you can't accept her and acknowledge her, you ain't going to get her gifts. Let's keep reading. My story of the constellations will tell of three young women who were sisters before the creation of the heavens and the earth, who insisted that they be allowed to come to earth at the same time. See that? That's why Christ said, everywhere I walk, the three Marys is with me. Everywhere I walk, the three Marys is with me. Mary, his mother, his sister, and Mary Magdalene. Everywhere I walk, the three sisters is with me. Who insisted that they be allowed to come to the earth at the same time, to be together and to be an inspiration to others, and who in death were assigned to the three stars in Orion's belt. You know what I'm saying? And their task now is to watch over the great beauty and power and energy of the great nebula, which represents the beauty and the power and energy that gives to each of us, each of the chosen children, the elect. So if you cannot accept the mother and worship the mother, you want to still worship the father, go right ahead. But Christ told you in John chapter 4, verse 22, ye worship who ye not know. And then they responded, we know who we worship. We worship the Father in spirit and in truth. See, they didn't know at that time. They kept worshiping the Father. But Christ said, you worship who ye not know. It's going to come a time when you're going to worship the Father. You're going to worship the Mother. And if you ain't worshiping the Mother, you will not receive her gifts. See what I'm saying? So you can accept this, or you can just throw it in the trash. It's up to you. But remember, if you cannot accept the Mother and worship the Mother, you will not receive her gifts. That's why the Bible said, first I will send for preachers and teachers, and they shall teach. Then I shall send for hunters, and they shall hunt. The hunter is Christ, Horus, Marduk. You know what I'm saying? Or you, the hunter, and your true power is the three sisters, Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Right there on the screen, Christ at the Last Supper, he got the three sisters in the hidden hand. Right behind him is Barbilo. On the right hand is Pistis. On the left hand is Mary Magdalene, Sophia. You know what I'm saying? And all the 12 disciples. That's why the Divine Mother gave me that picture. I ain't never seen that picture before. The first picture on my video, when it got the black woman reaching down, touching the king and the baby. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? That's your true power and your true strength. Christ said to himself, ye worship who you not know. You worshiping the Father, and you're supposed to be worshiping the Mother. You know what I'm saying? The three stars of Orion's belt is your true power. Barbilo, Pisces, and Sophia. Christ said, I walk with three Marys at all times. That is his true power and his true strength. That's why the Catholic Church said, we must hide the Divine Mother from the children of Israel. Because that is their true strength and their true power. Let's move on. Look at the glory. Look at that. Look at that. The whole world. Look at that. Gaza pyramids. The three sisters. The three pyramids. I'm going to show you too, that the physical world represents the masculine principle. The World Trade Center in New York, the three buildings before they knocked them down. The three buildings before they knocked them down in New York. The World Trade Center, the three towers. See that? See that? The whole world worshiped the Mother, they just don't know it. And on the right-hand side, Orion's belt. See that? Barbilo, Pistis, in Sophia. See what I'm saying? The whole world worships the Mother and they don't even know it. That's why Christ said in John chapter 4, verse 22, ye worship who ye not know. What? Ye worship who ye not know what? You worshiping the Mother and you don't even know it. Israel. Ye worship the Mother and ye not know it. That's why Christ said, it's going to come a time when you ain't going to worship the Father no more. See what I'm saying? Y'all can refute this all you want, Israelites, who's so arrogant and ego, all up in your ego. You can stand your ego because you ain't going to get them gifts, arrogant brothers. Keep worshiping the Father. You ain't going to get her gifts. And she told you that. Christ told you that. You know what I'm saying? Ye know not who you worship. It said, what he said, ye know not who you worship. I mean, ye know not what you worship. You know what I'm saying? So y'all can be arrogant all you want and stay in your ego. Go right ahead. But you ain't going to get her gifts. And you're going to wish one day you had a worship the Divine Mother. All over the world, they worshiping the mother and don't even know it. Let's move on. Look at this. China. Same thing. China. Same thing. Look at China. See the three pyramids? Angkor Wat in China. Angkor Wat in China. See that? China even worshiping the mother and don't even know it. Gaza, Egypt, the three pyramids. Mexico, the three pyramids. Look on the right-hand side. Orion's belt. Now check this out. Newt is the upright angle. The pyramid facing up. The Star of David. The Star of David. See how the Star of David got so many different meanings? That's why I said you can't put one meaning on nothing. The Star of David. You see the pyramid facing up? That's Newt in Egypt. That's the physical aspect, the Holy Spirit. The pyramid facing down is the physical world. You know what I'm saying? Look at each one of the top pictures. You see the Y on them? The reason why the Divine Mother made it go to a Y, an angle like that, because she was telling you that I am the power of the physical world. That's what she was showing you. I am the power. See that Y? See the Y, what it make? That's why she moved one of the pyramids on an angle, meaning the masculine principle, the X and the Y chromosome. See that? A left got the X and the Y in it. A left. See the Y? The physical world. She is the power of the physical world. Look at the right-hand side, Orion's belt. See the Y it make? See that? She is the true power of the masculine principle. She is the one to give you she the one to teach your hands how to war and your fingers how to fight. That's why Christ said, ye worship who ye not know what. You think you worshiping the Father, but you don't know you worshiping the Mother, and you don't even damn know it. You know what I'm saying? The whole world loved these three symbols. The three stars of Orion belt, the three pyramids. The whole world go visit these pyramids all throughout the year. And they have no understanding what they're doing. You know what I'm saying? Look down at the bottom. Mexico, Egypt, Indonesia. See that? All y'all worshiping the mother and you don't even know it. All y'all worshiping the mother and you don't even know it. And a lot of y'all men, so damn arrogant and so much in your ego that you're not even going to acknowledge. You're not even going to acknowledge that the mother is your true power. Because y'all are that arrogant. Dang. I ain't want to go to that one. But it went anyway. You know what I'm saying? All of y'all in the world, y'all not even going to acknowledge that the mother is your true power. Because y'all are that arrogant in your head. And you so much in your ego and in the physical realm, you're not even going to acknowledge that you in your ego. And you ain't gonna acknowledge that the mother is the true power, the one who you worship. That's how arrogant y'all men are. Y'all gonna say, the deer going off, deer talking stupid, a deer ignorant, you know what I'm saying? A deer dumb, you know what I'm saying? Y'all gonna say all that, because y'all in y'all ego. You know what I'm saying? He done lost his damn mind. You know what I'm saying? A lot of y'all men gonna say that. A deer, he done lost his damn mind. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be in your ego. You know what I'm saying? But I done showed you proof that the three stars of Orion belt all over the world is the three mothers, Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Right at the Last Supper, you got Christ sitting at the table with the three mothers behind him, the three windows or the three doors. You know what I'm saying? The three women of creation, the three swirling circles, the three women of creation, Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Period, point blank. And y'all men, a lot of y'all men, gonna be in your ego and you gonna still deny it. But go right ahead. It's up to you. That's your free will and your choice. You know what I'm saying? But you ain't gonna be able to refute this video. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on. Now, I'm gonna show you when the gifts come, what you ain't gonna get. Let's move on. All right. Now, I'm in the book called The Starseed Transmission. The Starseed Transmission. Okay. It say, when the universe reaches a point of maximum expansion, meaning that the universe has ran out of the energy, it needs to be recharged again. That's why the Great Reset come every time. It gotta, bear with me. Every dang time, they always call on my video. Bear with me for a second. Okay. Now I'm going back to what I was saying. It say, when the universe reaches its maximum expansion, like I was saying, that's why a great reset come, because the universe has ran out of energy. You know when you read old ancient texts, it said the old gods got old and they got weak. They got old and weak. That means the universe need to be reset so it can get a recharge again. You know what I'm saying? It got to recharge the elements of the universe. That's why you have a great reset. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's talking about. So that's why, bear with me for a second. That's why you have a great reset. That's why you have a great reset, because the universe got to reset itself. So that's what's going on. That's what's going on. So that's why the universe had to reset and recharge itself. So that's where you're at right now. When the bill come, it's time to reset the universe every 36,000 years. You know what I'm saying? And say, when the universe reaches a point of maximum expansion, a unique phenomenon will take place. There will be a moment when all laws necessary for the creative maintenance of physical matter, see that? The creative maintenance of the physical matter. So the physical matter must be recharged every 36,000 years. It got to reset itself to get a new charge. Just like when you go to sleep every night, you got to be recharged. You got to recharge that matter, the physical body. Because if not, you'll collapse. That's what happened to the old gods. They ran out of energy. But when they reset, it's a longer period of time. Well, it's a 36,000 year reset. So then they come back. You know what I'm saying? So it's like the maintenance of the physical matter and all materializing processes become suspended. See that? It becomes suspended and it got to reset itself. So all physical reality gets suspended, meaning get destroyed and reset. You know what I'm saying? Due to the relative velocity of the various star systems. So what it's saying is the relative mean related. So all the stars line up for the great reset. You know what I'm saying? All the stars line up for the great reset. It say, this event will not be experienced simultaneously in all parts of the universe, but will travel as a wave across the sea. We'll read that again. That travel as a wave across the sea. That's why I was saying the Divine Mother, she is the water that sustains me across the oceans. She is the wave that carries me across the great sea. That's why I said that. She is the true divine wave that carries me across the great expanse, the great sea, the great mother. She is the power that do that. And say, this event will not be experienced simultaneously in all parts of the universe, but will travel as a wave across the sea of creation, existing within this ripple of non-time. Non-time mean it's not physical. You back to the divine mind. Like Thoth said, the universe is all mine. The great mind of the mother, Barbie, Pistis, and Sophia. It said this great ripple of non-time will be the focus consciousness. See that? Like Joseph, you're all mine. The universe is all mine. The great thought. It said we'll be the focus, conscious attention of the creator. See that? The creator, the divine mother, Barbie, the great creator, Metatron. I showed you that in the video. Metatron is feminine. You know what I'm saying? As it passes through the material realms, see that? She is the one to give all realms their power. She is the one to give all the physical world, like I showed you, the all the pyramids that line up with Orion's belt, and it make a Y, the X and Y chromosome. The X is the female, the Y is the male. The divine mother gives the male its power. And Orion belts show you that when the last pyramid, which is Sophia, is off on the angle, it make a Y. It give every male his power, his strength, his wisdom, and his knowledge. You know what I'm saying? He gives every male his wisdom, his power, his knowledge, his strength, and his power. The divine mother do all that. That's why Christ says it's going to come a time when you ain't going to worship the father. You're going to worship the mother like you're supposed to from the beginning. Sophia's earth. You know what I'm saying? You're going to go back to that. You know what I'm saying? And say, as it passes through the material realms, it will stay. See that? It will stay because the great rebirth. How can you have a rebirth without the mother present? How can you have a rebirth without the mother present? See, it say it will stay. How can you be born again without the mother present? Answer that, man. Any one of y'all men at the sound of my voice. How can you have a reset or a rebirth without the mother present? How can you be born again without the mother present? You tell me that, men in your ego. Tell me that. You can't have no baby. So how can you have a rebirth or be born again without the woman present? Your true power, your true strength, your true wisdom, and your true knowledge. It say, as it passes through the material realms, it will stay, rebirth, and take up residence in all life forms. See that? It will take residence in all life forms. So if any one of y'all men in y'all ego cannot accept the mother, you will not receive her gifts. Because she's going to take residence in every living thing, animals, trees, people, insects, Gentiles, everything. She gonna go on everything alive, and she gonna test it. She gonna test it. She gonna go on everything alive in the physical realm, and she gonna test it and see if it's worthy. She gonna test it and see if it's worthy. And if you ain't worthy, if you worthy, she gonna give you her gifts. If you in the middle, she is gonna give you joy, but you need some more training. But if you ain't worthy, she gonna kill you. If you ain't worthy, she gonna kill you. Plain and simple. And I'm gonna show you that. It say, and take up residence in all life forms with circuitry capable of mirroring this essence. See that? Let me read that again. It will stay and take up residency in all life forms with circuitry. Circuitry means DNA or DEA. Circuitry means DEA or DNA. I try to explain to y'all Gentiles over and over again. John 3:16 is a lie. Like the Bible say in Matthew 15:24, if I'm correct, the Most High or Christ came back only to the house of Israel. If you ain't got the circuitry, see how the white man try to put it where you won't get it? To my circuitry. He could have said DNA or DEA. He could have said that, but he probably put it in a way to try to make everybody inclusive, and that's not true. Because I'm telling you right here, if you ain't got the right circuitry or the DEA or DNA, you ain't chosen. I've been showing you all that over and over and over again in a lot of my videos that the Divine Mother blessed me to do. All of us is not chosen. Only Israel with the right DNA. That's why they give you the jab to try to destroy your DNA. Because every race on earth raped the true children of God. So we mixing every race on earth. That's why I say we scattered to the four corners of the earth. But it's a certain DNA, I'm saying that so you can get it, or DEA, that certain people have, that when this wave come, it's going to connect back with them. So John 3:16 is a bald-faced lie. It's not for everybody. Listen again. As this passes through the physical realm, material realm, it will stay and take up residence in all life forms with circuitry capable of mirroring this essence. So if you ain't got the proper DNA, which is the black people, the Anunnaki children, you know what I'm saying? The certain DNA, she gonna kill you. Period. Watch what it say. It say, those with the circuitry capable of mirroring or be like, when it say mirroring, it mean just like. Mirroring mean copy. Mirror mean copy. When you look in the mirror, you see yourself, a copy of you. So if you don't have the look or carbon, 666, like I told you, 666 is the mark of a beast or the mark of a man. Carbon. Six neutrons, six protons, six electrons, which mean carbon, which mean melanin, which mean the black man. You know what I'm saying? If you can't mirror this essence, you in trouble. You know what I'm saying? You in trouble. You know what I'm saying? Bear with me for a second. And these are facts. Okay. It say, read this for yourself in green. See it in green? It say, and take up residence in all life forms. That's why the Hopi say, you must get back to nature. Nature is Mother Nature. The Hopi said that. You must get back to nature. That's what the Hopi said. Get back to nature. Mother Nature. The mother. Get back to nature. The Metronetter. Get back to the mother. The Hopi even told you that. It say, residence in all life forms with circuitry capable of mirroring its essence. So if you ain't got the right DNA, you in trouble. It say, this is the movement when the creator will slip into creation. The moment we are attempting to prepare you for. This is the much misunderstood second coming of Christianity. See that? The misunderstood. Ain't gonna be no damn rapture. That wave gonna come. And it's gonna wake up your DNA or your DEA. And if you can't mirror that essence that come, she gonna kill you. Watch. It is the event that primitive civilizations have looked forward to as the return of the gods. See that? Don't the Bible say, ye are gods, but children of the Most High? See, the return of the gods. The gods are black people. 666, that fell into the flesh. Lucifer, which is Venus, which is Christ. Venus is Christ, I showed you all in my video. Venus is Christ, which is feminine. Lucifer is masculine, which is your physical body, which is the light bringer. That's why they call Lucifer the light bringer. Because that's your physical body going to raise your kundalini back up and you're going to become Christ or Venus once again. You know what I'm saying? It say, this is the event that primitive civilizations have looked forward to as the return of the gods. The Mayans, see that? The Mayans, the Hopis, the Aztecs, the niggers, went so far as to point it actual occurrence in what we would call the year 2011. See, that's when all of us woke up. 2011. You know what I'm saying? They done messed up the calendar, but we woke up in 2011. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the next page. Okay. It said, to those of the human race who have turned themselves into the will of God, to coming intervals, the coming intervals of non-time, talking about the wave, the coming intervals, meaning it's going to come in intervals, like a wave, of non-time will literally expand into eternity. These individuals will be able to experience a lifetime or many lifetimes. See that? The water. When you drink this water, you shall never thirst again. When you drink this water, you shall have eternal life. Christ told you that. The water of the mother. You know what I'm saying? Or many lifetimes in that eternity. See that? When you drink this water, you shall have eternal life. He was talking about the mother. When you come back to the mother, you shall have eternal life. Christ was telling you that the whole damn time. You know what I'm saying? While still retaining the option to return to the physical projections. See that? You can return to the physical body like Christ did to help others. While still retaining the option to return to their physical projections, the avatars, as transformed representatives of the being of life on earth, talking about Christ. There will be others co-workers. There will be our co-workers during the period of planetary awakening. See that? Others not so finely tuned. See that? Others not so finely tuned. See that? All of y'all that's woke, but you won't accept the mother, you ain't finely tuned yet. You know what I'm saying? To the forces that will be released at that time will feel great surges of energy lasting for an indeterminate period. Some few will experience, go to the bottom half, will experience an intensive fear. The Colburn Bible tell you that. The Keys of Enoch tell you that. Intensive fear means some of y'all are going to go straight stone cold crazy. That's why it said the wave or energy of the divine mother or conscious mind going to go in all of creation. Gentiles, insects, animals, trees, everything. Chosen people. Some of y'all are going to go into fear and go crazy. The Keys of Enoch tell you that. The Colburn Bible tell you that. Enoch tell you that. Your Thoth tell you that. Some of y'all are going to go crazy. That's why I'm going to go in all of creation. So that's why I say, if y'all refuse to accept the mother, that's up to you. That's you. You the one ain't going to receive the gifts. Because when that wave come and you ain't received the mother and you ain't worshiping the mother, you worship who you know not what. If you ain't worshiping the mother, you're going to go crazy. Some of y'all. Listen what it say. It say, some few will experience a intense fear. That's why the book of Enoch said you're going to go crazy. The Keys of Knowledge. You're going to go crazy. The Return of the Dove. You're going to go crazy. And many will die. Wait a minute. And many will die. Wait a minute. And many will die. Wait a minute. And many will die. Some of y'all are going to die because you didn't receive the mother. And a lot of y'all Gentiles that hate the mother. That's why the Catholic Church said, we must never let Israel know about the mother, their true strength and their true power. It say, some few will experience an intense fear. Then you're going to go straight stone cold crazy. You're going to be zombies. You're going to be zombies. You're going to go straight stone cold crazy. Like the Colburn Bible in the book of Enoch said, and Thoth said, you know what I'm saying? And many will die. See that? She going to kill you. Because you ain't worthy. So all of y'all men with the ego that can't accept the mother, look forward to going crazy or die. It's up to you. It's your free will. But you will not deny this video today because you cannot refute this information. The mother herself worked through me to bring this out. Now refute it if you want to. You know what I'm saying? It say, and many will die. See, I circled that at the bottom paragraph. and say kill. See what I'm saying? And many will die. Everything in the physical form at this time, every soul in every kingdom will feel something incredible. And everybody ain't got no soul, so they ain't talking to everybody. Something that according to all the laws of psyche, you know what I'm saying, the universal laws, ever known or ever to be discovered could never happen. See that? Let me read that again for you. And say something incredible, something that I'll skip the line. It says something that according to all the laws of psyche ever known or ever to be discovered could never happen. See, something gonna happen to you that you thought was never possible. That's what it's saying. How magnificent and beautiful it's gonna be. You ain't gonna thought it would never could be possible. You know what I'm saying? The strangeness of our salvation, far greater than when you first believed. See that? You even never thought this would be possible. You know what I'm saying? But there it will be before all senses. See that? The senses in your body. Your five senses is going to overwhelm them. That's why I be telling y'all, it overwhelmed my senses of the physical body. It's an impossible fact, like the baby in the manger. See, talking about Christ. It's telling you right there, it say, like the baby in the manger. It means you're going to be Christ. That's why I said all of y'all are Christ, but children of the Most High. So it's going to make you like Christ. When the dove came down on him and he was make the dead, raising the dead, making the blind see, making the lame walk, making the deaf hear, making water in the wine. See, it's going to make all of y'all Christ. See, it say, before all senses, an impossible fact, like the baby in the manger, it's going to make all of y'all Christ. That's why I say, stop looking for some white man coming out the sky. You Christ, Lucifer. Lucifer and Christ is the same thing. Lucifer is the lower aspect. Christ is the upper aspect. You know what I'm saying? Your kundalini down in hell, Lucifer, and it raise up the heaven to your pineal gland, and it make you Christ. Bottom line, it's like the baby in the manger, like the unmistakable feeling in your heart. That's why she said she's going to weigh your heart. If you ain't worthy, you're going to go crazy or you're going to die. You know what I'm saying? If you can't match that essence, if you ain't the chosen elect, you know what I'm saying? John 3:16 is a bald-faced lie. Matthew 15:24, I only came for the house of Israel. You know what I'm saying? It say, in your heart, and while my yachts, I'm going to weigh your heart. An incredible vibration of truth. See that? Incredible vibration of truth. Truth is Sophia, Pistis, and Barbilo. And love. See that? Truth and love. Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia. Simultaneously, syntilling, that means brightness. That means you're going to shine like the stars of heaven. See that? It's a shimmering or syntilling means shining or brightness. Don't the Bible say you're going to shine like the stars of heaven? This right here telling you that. A vibration of truth and love. Shimmering or syntilling meaning shine bright. Look that up. It means shining brightly. And when the Bible says you're going to shine like the stars of heaven, she's going to make you a hunter. You know what I'm saying? She's going to make you Christ. The hunter is Christ or Adam Catman. You know what I'm saying? Awakening every nerve. See that? Every nerve, every capillary, every cell of your planetary body. See that? You're going to be Adam Catman. Adam Catman is Christ. That's why they say the first Adam was Christ, reborn as Messiah. And that is right. So if you can't accept the mother, which is the great wave, Barbilo, Pistis, and Sophia, you in trouble. You will not receive her gifts. So I thank the divine mother Netta for giving me understanding to do her work and her will. If any man in his ego and you can't accept this, it's up to you. So glory to the divine Metaneta. I give thanks to the angel of ether. I give thanks to the angel of water. I give thanks to the angel of earth. I give thanks to the angel of fire. And I give thanks to the angel of air, the divine Metaneta. Peace and love, brothers and sisters. I thank y'all for coming out. I thank y'all for watching the video. If you can't receive this, it's totally up to you. You know what I'm saying? But this is truth and this is facts. You know what I'm saying? The divine mother told me to do this video in my dream. And she said the women are waking up now. Women, black women are waking up everywhere. It's their turn now. And we men must help them. That's why she said I need specific men that can accept the truth of the divine mother. Christ told you the same thing. Woman, it's going to come a time when you will not worship the Father, for ye know not who ye worship. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, brothers and sisters, thank y'all for coming out. Peace be unto you, brothers and sisters. Shalom.
God is my friend. God is my friend. He made this world for us to live in. And gave us everything. And all the answers.